and gentlemen, Vision. and everything that has breath. Or you can do better than that, let everything, I'm going to try one more time, let everything that has breath that, I know the word breathalyzer normally means something else, but I wish you could test your own breath to see if you qualify. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Anthem of Praise. A salute to Richard Smallwood. I'm sure you can tell by now that we are in for quite a treat tonight. I heard Vision rehearsing the other day, and I had to leave because I was about to lose all my decorum and all my composure. But that's all right. I hope tonight you will let go of some of the restraints. And since you got breath, you'll go ahead and praise the Lord. How about that? My name is Braxton D. Shelley. I'm an associate professor here in the Department of Music, Institute of Sacred Music, and the Divinity School. And my favorite part of my job is that I'm faculty director of the program in Music in the Black Church. And it is under that heading that I get to welcome you to College Street Music Hall. Maybe we can change the name tonight and call it College Street Baptist, Methodist Church of God in Christ, by faith in prophecy. How about that? I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be here, glad to see so many wonderful musicians. Some of the leading lights of American music are going to be on this stage. This stage tonight. And it is an appropriate thing because from the prelude to the postlude, the music of Richard Smallwood is the soundtrack of so many of our churches. You can start in Smallwood and end in Smallwood and have a good time. Not just on Sunday morning, but all throughout the week. We can count on the catalog of Richard Smallwood to lift us, to light a path out of darkness, to fill us, and to feed us. And so it is my proud privilege to introduce tonight's honoree. I'm going to ask you to get up on your feet and lose your mind for a second with a loud round of applause and welcome for the one and only Richard Smallwood. Yesterday from someone who lost their child in the Sandy Hook school tragedy, and she said, Richard's music saved my life. And that was not a hyperbole. She meant that. She said, I waited 12 years to tell him thank you. Lots of folks in here have their own story. You may not get to tell them tonight, but you can enjoy the music and signify with your praise just how deeply his music, his work has affected your life. We're going to go on now and bring to the stage one of the leading operatic and virtuosic voices in the country, operatic countertenor, John Holliday. John Holliday is here tonight, despite ongoing rehearsals at the Metropolitan Opera. He said, I had to be here to honor this legend. And when you hear, you will understand why we had to have him here tonight. This is a voice you'll hear once in a generation, and I hope you will follow him. Go to the Met, support his career. He's about to blow us all away. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Y'all having a good time tonight? That's one of my favorite Smallwood songs. That bridge gets me. You just keep on proving yourself. Over and over and over. You get stuck right there, but I won't because we got to move on. But he's the same God. Chance. I almost wouldn't be here tonight. I would really prefer to be in Raleigh, North Carolina in a hospital with my grandmother. But she said, go do your job. She's had a problem in every system in her body this year. And every time I got scared, I heard that song. He's the same God. So I had to write some new lyrics and said, well, the God of the kidneys is also God of the liver. And the God of the liver can also deal with anemia. And the God who can handle the blood can also handle the skin. He's the same. And that's what we're back there. Somebody's had a year like mine, you know. Those are not just pretty words, but that's the truth. He's the same God. There are some voices that you hear and you never forget. Some voices that define what singing is. We're about to hear from one of those voices now. Grammy Award winning singer. Member of a musical dynasty. First Lady of the Church of God in Christ. And just a stone singer. Give it up for Karen.
On behalf of the sisters also, we love you. So So we're going to try to do this. Well, I'm going to try. I know Vision got it. But I'm going to try to do this. Hope this bless you.
Thank you.
Told you. Yeah. Secret place, a place where I can go. Putting on something like this takes a lot of work and a lot of partners. I want to take a second now just to acknowledge all the partners at the university who have taken time and resources to help us honor this man and this music. I'm so grateful for the generosity of the Faculty of Arts and Sciences Dean's Office, Yale Divinity School, Yale School of Music, Yale University Chaplain's Office, Yale's Office of Diversity and Inclusion, Yale School of the Arts, the David Geffen School of Drama at Yale. Well, up there, I hear you. The Yale School of Medicine, the doctors love you, Richard. Yale School of the Environment, the Department of Religious Studies, the Department of English, the Department of Music, the Department of African American Studies, the Afro-American Cultural Center, the Whitney Humanities Center, Theater and Performance Studies, the Yale Schwarzman Center, and the Office of Belonging at Yale. That's how many partners it took to bring this together. And it was an easy ask, because as soon as you say the word Richard Smallwood, the name Richard Smallwood, folks know the seriousness, the significance, and the worthiness of this endeavor. I've also had a creative partner in this endeavor who I've gotten to work with, an amazing musician in his own right, Grammy Award-winning composer and producer. Karen Clark Sheard just said that he is her advisor. And he's been my advisor on putting together this amazing event that's just beginning. I want to bring him to the stage now to thank him for what he's done to help us and to give him a chance to speak about what Richard Smallwood means to him. Give it up for Donald Lawrence.
Good evening, everyone. Wow, what an amazing evening. Richard, man, I love you. I love you, man. It's been such a pleasure to just work with Dr. Shelley on this event and helping curate these songs. It's so many, it was hard to choose. So, you know, Richard means a lot to me. He was definitely a big influence on my career and how I approach my music. You know, I was talking in the master class the other day that when I was at CCM, which is the Cincinnati Conservatory of Music, I was studying musical theater, and I kind of used that to shape my music, but it was more Broadway. But hearing Richard's approach with classical music to his gospel, it really gave me even more courage to put a little bit more of the Broadway theater into my music. So it was really beautiful. And it, you know what, I think that iron sharpens iron, and when you see one creative, it teaches you to that you can be creative at your own thing. So I wanted to just really say that and just to thank him. It's so wonderful that you all came out, and you know, I reached out to a lot of these artists, and didn't you guys enjoy everybody that came out so far? John was literally starting a role this weekend at the Met. He's in rehearsal, and he actually had to get permission to leave at rehearsal to come and do this with us. So show him some love again. He was able to take off a couple of days. And then, of course, my sister, who this is my sister, Karen Clark Sheard, and she's just that thing. And then, you know, I don't get, he's one of my best friends, but I don't get to hear him that much. Brother Ted Wynn was doing some good singing up here. but listen, we got a good more to come. Listen, don't leave, because we got some great singing coming. It's just a wonderful catalog. And what I was trying to do is let this 100 voice choir get up here. And I think we all good, right? We all good? We good? Okay, cool. So, I'm good.
Let me thank one other person. You know him too.
I know.
Well, we don't got so many to thank. I want to thank Sigmund for organizing this party.
Hey, Sigmund. Can we bring down the audience just a little bit?
Pastor Sigmund Morier.
I've been doing this for a long time. My friend, put together this mass choir. And you guys, we got another opera star in the house who reached out to me. We got Miss Denise Graves from the Man also in the house. Please show them. Stand up and let them see you. Oh, yeah.
We'll be having other special guests tonight that we'll bring on in time. Okay, now, we want to make way for this wonderful community choir, folks who've given up 5 Friday evenings to come together and to learn this wonderful music. Let me also thank our vocal director for tonight, Dwayne Woods.
I'm getting old, so I make Dwayne come and do it now. I don't do it as much anymore, but he's learned well, and he handles it really, really good. One more time for Dwayne Woods.
Let's give it up for the community choir as they come with the highest praise.
Thank you. Community choir sounds good, don't they? There are some last names in gospel that are just without peer. You could start calling them and you might get in trouble if you leave some out, but there's one last name that signifies so much history, shifting from traditional and the golden age of gospel into contemporary gospel music. And there is a voice. Think about songs like Changed. Going Up Yonder. A voice that set the standard that all these years later still clears her own standard. She is a close personal friend, counts as family, our honoree for tonight, and came all the way from California to be with us. I'm talking about the one and only Lady Tramaine Hawkins.
Looking at a piece that we did on television, and you talked a little and I talked a little, brought back such wonderful memories, Richard. I could go on and go on and on and on, and my sister just left the stage, Sister Karen, and giving accolades where accolades are due. But I want you to know that your ministry, your songs ministered to me. I had you on YouTube all day today.
My Lord.
Listening from song to song to song to song. All these singers from way back, they had, it was almost like they knew tonight was your night. So, my brother, I'm looking forward. I don't want to have any regrets like I did with our good friend and his family too. He's gone on to be with the Lord. Andre, I did one song with him. I'm gonna do songs with you. Am I right? So let's work on that. I love the Lord, everybody. Do you love the Lord? Do you love the Lord? I said, do you love the Lord?
Thank you.
not understand this song is just not a song. It's a reality. No matter what goes on in my life, I found out that I can depend on Jesus. And it's nothing that I earn, but his love. There's nothing much to say other than thank you. Thank you for your talent. Thank you for your heart. You know, and it's I say it's a wonderful thing when you don't have to really be a great singer to sing one of your songs. Because when you got a good song, you can have an okay singer. That's why I'm here tonight.
Help yourself.
But we love you. And I think it's important, I really do think it's important, that we say we love you while you're still alive. Sometimes we wait too late to honor these icons and these people that have blessed us. You know, I know your song has brought me through storms. And so I thank you. I really do honor you. I love you with all my heart. Lady Tramaine and Karen and all. You know, okay, I'm just gonna do my song.
Help yourself.
Come on!
Ladies and gentlemen, can you please have your seats? Please have your seats.
Gilead.
as God helps us to return to our seats. Y'all gonna be able to do that? Help us to return to our seats. So how y'all feel about the first half of this? Yeah. I was supposed to introduce BeBe. I had planned all this nice stuff I was gonna say, you know. I talked about the last name. I was gonna go from Hawkins to Winans, you know. And then the spirit stepped on my plan. Well, that's what we came for. We came to honor this man and to give praise to the one who gave Richard Smallwood the gifts he's used to bless the man of God. I hope y'all are having fun because I'm having a great time. I told someone, I said, I planned this event, and then when I saw the people, I was like, oh my God, that's Karen Clark Sheard, and that's Tramaine Hawkins, and that's BeBe Winans. Richard, your music has gathered a cloud of witnesses on earth. And you've been such a blessing to so many. We thanked our partners already. I want to thank those of you who came yesterday to Marquand Chapel. We had a wonderful masterclass and conversation. We've heard already that the wonderful singer Denise Graves is in the house, but somebody who wrecked us yesterday, Brittany Stewart, I saw her back there too. She sang Healing until the balm from Gilead came to New Haven. She talked about how Richard's music has been an inspiration to her, and it's true. Your influence spans generations. There is a group of siblings who have come to pay tribute. They've come to show you how much your music, how much your ministry has meant to them. And they are coming now to the stage with their rendition of one of your classic songs. Give it up for the Walls group.
Because of those things, we are blessed because of you. So we want to thank you. One song that you have written that we have been singing for now, I don't know, a long time, has really ministered to our family. So it says,
won't you trust me? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the stage, Donald Lawrence and Vision.
Show some love to the walls one more time. Singers, I thought I would push them a little bit. They said they hadn't really sang together for about a couple of years. So I've been cracking the whip a little bit this week. I've been cracking the whip, but I get it honestly. And before we do this, have y'all been enjoying Vision tonight, y'all? Yeah. Just before we do this song, will y'all please introduce yourselves to each other, starting to the right here. Just a little bit louder.
Vanessa Williams.
Yes.
Lori K. Yeah. Sly.
One more time.
Lori K. Sly. Rhonda Burnett Chapman.
Dale Atterbury from Connecticut. Ted Wood from the Church of God in Christ.
Benefit Nichols.
Sharice Nelson.
Yeah. Renee Adams.
Yeah. Colette
Brown. Listen. Colette just had a number one song in the country. Y'all show us some love. And this is Vision, everybody. This is the Richard Smallwood Band under the direction of Brian Hugh. Show him some love. All right, we're gonna do this little song, and it's an arrangement that one of those things that, you know, these days people rehearse on their way to church with the songs. And I don't do those songs. I do the songs that you got to rehearse, okay? You can't do my song. You can't learn my songs on the way to church, and you can't learn your songs on the way to church either. Because if you do, you sing the wrong parts. So these songs right here, you got to rehearse them. Even they got to rehearse them, and they recorded them. So, you know, so we're going to do this song right here. And it's a song that I loved. Just the way it was written, the story in it, how visual it is. And I'm going to ask Vanessa to come in and sing this a little bit. All right?
Thank you. Thank you. there any grateful people in here tonight?
Thank you. Yeah.
words for what transpired since the last time I was on the stage. Singing in praise that's taking place, and I almost took a lap. Messed me up real good, and I gotta try to figure out how to get back together. Richard, your music has inspired so many. I'll never forget the first time I heard your piano solo on It Is Well, Come Ye Disconsolate.
Yes, yes, yes.
I was an undergraduate, I was trying to learn how to play. I stopped after that. Ain't no need. I attempt to master that, but you have inspired instrumentalists and vocalists. And like John Holliday, who sang at the beginning, tonight we have a special guest. Now, Broadway has just done a major reboot of The Wiz. And the music supervisor, orchestrator, and arranger of The Wiz has been kind of busy this week. It opened on Wednesday night. But when we talked to him, he said, I have got to come and honor Richard. The piano before us is gonna turn into some kind of combustion engine in just a second, because coming to the stage now, one of the great versatile musicians, a composer and arranger and orchestrator, a leader and a pianist, to play his arrangement of one of your best known songs. Let's give it up for Joseph Joubert.
Thank you.
such a fitting honor to an amazing maestro. Richard, we hope that tonight has been a blessing to you in some way, that the musical tributes from all of your peers and those who came after you have given a sense of just how much you mean to so many people. But we didn't want you to leave the city of New Haven without having a more official recognition of your significance both to this place and to the entire country. So the mayor's office sent something to be said to you and to all of those who gathered here, something to proclaim the significance of what you contributed, both to gospel music, to American music, and to music across around the world.
To God be the glory.
Yes.
I start with to God be the glory because while I stand here representing one government, I know that there is another government that you only access by spirit and truth, that you, Mr. Smallwood, have access, and they ensure that you will receive that which I hold in my hand. My name is Miles Riley, and in addition to being Dr. Braxton Shelley's student at Yale Divinity School, I serve as administrator of mission within the Department of Arts, Culture, and Tourism, which is directed by Adrian Jefferson in the city of New Haven. And we honor you today on behalf of Mayor Elliker with these words. Proclamation of the City of New Haven honoring Richard Smallwood. Whereas the City of New Haven, in partnership with Yale University, honors Mr. Richard Smallwood as a vanguard of gospel and American music. Whereas the City of New Haven values and celebrates the arts and the artistic and cultural contributions of its residents and beyond. Whereas Mr. Smallwood, the winner of Grammy, Dove, and Stellar Awards, known by many throughout the world, has for more than five decades composed the soundtrack of countless worship services, including services in New Haven, with songs such as Total Praise,
yes.
Center of My Joy,
yes.
My Everything,
yes.
Healing,
yes.
And the namesake of tonight's concert, Anthem of Praise.
Yes.
Whereas Mr. Smallwood is known for his skillful synthesis of the best of the Black gospel tradition and musical elements from Western classical traditions. Whereas Mr. Smallwood has undoubtedly enriched the lives of New Haven residents through his contributions to New Haven arts, music, and spirituality. Now, therefore, do I, as mayor of the City of New Haven, hereby honor and recognize Mr. Richard Smallwood. We at the City of New Haven join with scholars, musicians, students, and members of the New Haven community in honoring Mr. Richard Smallwood and his artistic contributions to New Haven. In testimony whereof, I have hereunto subscribed my name and caused the seal of the City of New Haven to be affixed, dated at New Haven, Connecticut, this 19th day of April, in the year 2024, Mayor Justin Elliker. Can we all stand to our feet and give Mr. Smallwood just a round of applause? Thank you for your contributions to New Haven, to our lives, and to this entire world.
Second, we're all going to become one big choir. We get to sing Total Praise. But before that, we want to hear from the man himself. Take all the time you want. The floor is yours.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. If you love the Lord, let me hear you say, I love him. Give him a hand clap right now. Thank you so much. Oh, this has been one of the most amazing nights of my life. I would like to thank my friend Braxton for making all this happen. As he said, he became friends when he was an undergrad, and now he's a doctor. And he did his dissertation from his PhD on my music. To read that is like reading something that someone else did, not me. It is the most amazing document I think I've ever read. I was reading and I was like, did I do that? But I thank God for him. I thank Yale University for this wonderful, 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 wonderful honor. You guys have been so good, so loving. I can't express my appreciation enough to all of you for the love you've shown me. I've had the best 3 days of my life that I can remember here at Yale. With the masterclass we had yesterday, it was so much fun. And of course tonight, first of all, I want to thank my little brother, Donald Lawrence. Yeah. Donald, I love you so much. You're such a genius. I just praise God for you and your love as a brother. I thank you so much. So proud of you. Just keep doing what you're doing. Be unmistakably you. Whatever God gives you, keep doing it. Keep doing what he gave you. Not what nobody else thinks or what nobody else says. I remember when I first started out, I was told that my music didn't make sense by the powers that be in the industry because of that classical influence. Why did you put that mess, that classical mess on the end of Calvary? That's what I heard. You know, I grew up listening to classical music and gospel music. Thank God to my mama. And so I always tell people, whatever God has called you to do, to stay true to your calling. If we all sounded the same, if we all played the same, if we all sang the same, what a boring world this would be. But what makes it so interesting is that there's so much uniqueness that God has given this world. And so I thank you. I thank all these wonderful singers. My dear friend, two of my favorite sopranos on the planet, Karen Clark Sheard and Tramaine Hawkins. I can't. Tramaine and I go back to the time we were teenagers. We were both teens when I met Tramaine. She was singing with the Edwin Hawkins Singers, and I wanted to be an Edwin Hawkins Singer. And so thank God for them. For BeBe, I've known BeBe for years and years. For his love and for his amazing gift and spirit that he has. What can I say about Joseph Joubert? What can I say? I mean, I said it with tears in my eyes because, you know, when you write these songs, you have no idea what God is going to do. You have no idea where they're going to go. I wrote I Love the Lord when I was 23 years old. Who knew that Whitney Houston would have sung it? I mean, you just never know what God... So stay true to whoever you are. God has purpose in your gift. He has purpose in your life. What can I say about my favorite singers on the entire planet? And that's Busy. Don't y'all start me crying. Listen, I formed this group in, 1995, yes. The first song I think we did was Thank You, on our first rehearsal. And we still sing it however many of these are years later. But you know I love you all. This was such a pleasant surprise. I had no idea you guys were going to be here. People kept slipping and saying something about Vision. I was like, Vision? They said, oh, we met somebody else. I was like, oh, okay. And then when I walked out here and I saw you guys, when I was rolled out here, and I saw you guys, my heart just leapt for joy. Thank you. For my Vision band, Brian Q. I'm not sure how long Brian has been playing for me. Probably 35 years, 40? Probably so. He was with me through the Smallwood singing era, and he's still with me today. To Mike Pugh, to everybody, thank you so much for my bass player. You know I love you. God, there's so many people. I don't want to give out anybody. Is Tony here? Hey, Tony! one of the most amazing keyboard players in the world, Brother Tony Walker. Amen. Amen. I was doing an interview earlier today, and I was talking about my musicians and how I really like to give them freedom to do what they want to do on my music. I want them to be free to improvise, to add that little piece of spice to the things that I do. And I'm saying it with my singers. Vision Band, I love you guys so much. To this wonderful choir. Thank you so much to Dwayne Woods, my friend. Good Dwayne, thank you. Love you so much. We go back so many years. It's just so good to see everybody. Thank you. Whoever I've left out, please. Who? The Walls Group, yes. I heard them first sing Trust Me at the Chicago Gospel Fest. And I stepped on stage and cried. I mean, I was listening to these young people. I'm like, I'm of age. And these are babies singing these songs that I've written, that God gave me. And so I'm so grateful for them. And so thank you so much to everybody. Did I leave somebody out? Oh, John Holliday, the wonderful, wonderful, wonderful voice of God. What an amazing, amazing gift. What a wonderful gift he was. Singing one of my favorite songs, which is sort of really on the classical vein. So it was a blessing to hear him. Everybody who's come out tonight, thank you for support. For your love. I've got friends who showed up and surprised me who I had no idea were coming. And I just thank you and love everybody. Thank you so much, Bracken. God bless you. I don't see really well sometimes. My drummer, my friend, Brother Elliot on the drums. Amen. Hey, Elliot.
So tonight's benediction will be a collective one. I think everybody here knows the words to this song. We heard it rendered on the instrument. Now we get to render it with our voices. And so I think Donald's going to conduct it.
Hey, you guys, there's a couple more people. I want to thank sound and lights. And you see this guy right here? He's got a wonderful choir in Chicago. He's a great choir director, but he also does logistics and handles staging, and he's been running this whole thing production-wise. This is Mark Pepper right here. He and his whole team has kept everybody on point, sound checks, and everything to Jared, production manager. So we all show some love to the whole production team. That's how we were able to move this thing so smoothly. They've done an incredible job. And now I'm not directing anything.
Well, I'm not either, so I think it's only you, Dwayne. Let's all stand up. We know this song. Let's go out together and song. It's all the place.